I know we've talked about a lot of the negative stuff, but did anything positive happen? I'll tell you, for me, it has been great to be at home with my family, and I have a four-year-old and a six-year-old. I got to spend a lot of time with them. There's been a lot of craziness with that as well, but it's been nice to be, to kind of not have to go out, not have to do anything, but just kind of be at family. Like, anyone else have like a silver lining in this 2020?
I got to learn news.
Oh yeah, Leslie, my favorite thing is you watching MSNBC.
I'm honest with you when I say, when I went to SNL, I didn't know nothing. Like, it's like when I hear people talking, when you hear normal people talking about politics and things that's going on in the world, and then I come to SNL and it's a whole different level of knowledge that you, and I'm a regular person, so it's like, yeah, I didn't know that there's a Senate and a Congress, and they work right together, and Democrats and Republicans. Wait a minute. So, I mean, so these people, I mean, it's so much stuff I didn't know. So, like, through this whole thing, all I've been doing watching is news and actually learning things that you're going, oh my God, how did we not know this? And maybe I wasn't watching news before because I didn't want to get stressed out. Yeah. Because now I'm completely stressed out. But it's like, because now I didn't know stuff. It's like, oh, wait a minute. And this is why I'm saying this, is because a lot of normal people think things are being taken care of. Like, right, they really do think that the government takes care of us, and they really do think this is how this is working. And it's, I mean, I know people who go, yeah, it's just the flu. I mean, like, we,
right,
it's almost like I can empathize with regular people, but, you know, people who are living normal lives.
Well, yeah,
that are not aware.
I think what you're talking about is something that I really noticed here in 2020, which is, like, because we were all at home, it allowed us to focus on certain things. I think that that's why, you know, especially here in the States, like, you know, social issues and this racial, you know, reawakening that we've all had was because there was nowhere else to look, right? And I think we're living this life where, okay, yes, something's taken care of for me. We can move and move and move. And this is a chance for us to kind of really hone in on that. And I think, you know, that's great. Anybody else? Anything else? Another silver lining of 2020?
Go ahead.
Leslie, as you were talking, I was like, yes, exactly. Like, I'm so embarrassed that I used to sort of only pay attention to, like, the presidential election,
right,
and, like, whoever the mayor of New York was, and right, the governor, and then I was like, and the rest, I don't know. I can't believe it took me till this year to be like, oh, you have to research all the candidates because this person, this thing I've never heard of, affects all these things that affects all this stuff. Like, I think also for most of my life has been like, yeah, we vote for them and then they take care of it. And it's, and the sort of lack of participation has been, like, bone chilling to me. But I would say that that's, like, my biggest takeaway from this year is like, now I can't unsee that. And now,
I have to be responsible. I have to be responsible now. That, like, you know, oh my God, I didn't know that Mitch McConnell is the one who makes most of the, this is the reason why the president might not be able to do anything. I didn't know that. I'm just like, oh, he's just not doing it.
Right.
You know, so.
Yes, I know.
And I think it's about, like, showing up all year round. I think that's the thing that we're all kind of learning, is it's not just enough to go to one protest or do one vote or, you know, whatever it is. Camille, what about you? I know that you have spent a lot of time, you know, really, I think, really touting for people to be safe and you know, follow these protocols, which I think is so important too, because I think a lot of people feel like, oh, it doesn't affect them. So you've spent a lot of time at home. Has there been a positive lining to that?
Yeah, you know, the vaccine I've been working on came out real nice. It was this passion project, one for them, one for me kind of thing. And it just seemed to hit at just the right time. In all seriousness, though, this is true. I just got, I've been, you know, my wife is in a high risk group. So I've been very vocal about people trying to be careful and all this. And I just found out a weird positive side effect. I just got blood work done. And for the first time in my adult life, my cholesterol is in range for the first time, because for the last 9 months, I've been cooking every meal for myself, not been going out at all. I did not expect it. I thought it was somebody else's. I was like, wait, isn't this supposed to be red? Why is this green?
Yeah.
I love that. What about you, Joe?
Yeah, I feel like it's just like kind of what you're talking about, just taking a step back and just listening to other people and just kind of getting your head out of, you know, in this industry especially, it's like very easy to, you know, you're thinking about, you know, what things you're trying to do, goals that you might have, but it's nice to just sort of take a second and kind of listen to other people. And then I totally agree with just like researching your ticket, you know, make sure you're voting up and down the ballot. That's something that me and my girlfriend made a point to do this year, because it's just like, it is crazy to think about, you know, I would only sort of vote for the president and then just write the rest off. Just,
yeah, absolutely.
You know. Yeah.
What about you, Lisa?
Oh boy. Well, I mean, I have to say, I mean, every time there's a crisis, I realize how important entertainment is.
Right.
Because you need a break.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a big mental health issue too, you know?
Absolutely.
And so that's why I was like really happy to do this, you know, for let's laugh as soon as we can about it. And it's there for all time for when you are ready to laugh about
right,
it.
Right, exactly.
You know? And it was just, it wasn't the magnitude of crisis, it was the lunacy that accompanied it, you know?
Absolutely, yeah, no, I, yeah.